A Simple Life of Swami Vivekananda by Brahmachari Amal, published by Advaita Ashrama, Publication House of Ramakrishna Math, Belur Math. Chapter 1. Young Naren. Once a young man was walking along the streets of Calcutta. Suddenly he heard a great noise. What was it? Then he saw a carriage rushing along the street. The horse, pulling the carriage, was running as fast as it could. Something had frightened it, and it was running away. A lady was riding in the carriage, and she was badly frightened. She was in great danger, because the carriage might be upset at any moment. No one was able to help her. The young man saw what was happening. He was very brave. When the horse came close, he ran towards it at the risk of his own life, seized the reins and forced the horse to stop. The life of the lady was saved, and she was very grateful to the young man. Who was he? He was then called Narendranath, but he later became famous as Swami Vivekananda. He was born in a famous Datta family who lived in the similar section of Calcutta. Sri Vishwanath Datta was a lawyer. He had studied many things and was respected by everyone. His wife was Bhuvaneshwari Devi. She was like a queen in appearance as well as behavior. Everyone loved and respected her. On the 12th of January 1863, their first son was born. They named him Narendranath. Naren was a naughty child. And sometimes Bhuvaneshwari Devi found it extremely hard to control him. However, she found that even when Naren grew extremely restless, if cold water was poured on his head, at the same time chanting the name of Shiva in his ear, the child would quiet down. Indeed, at times, this was the only method with which to bring him under control. Young Naren learned many things from his mother. And she told him stories from the Mahabharata and the Ramayana. Naren loved to hear the story of Sri Rama. He bought a small clay image of Sita Rama and worshipped it with flowers. He liked to listen to the reading of the Ramayana. Once he stayed in a banana grove for a long time, hoping to see Sri Hanuman, for he had heard that that was a favorite place of this heroic devotee of Rama. He also liked to play at meditation. He would take one or two of his friends to a lonely place and they would sit in front of an image of Sita Rama or Shiva. Then Naren would meditate and would think about God. He would get lost in his thoughts about God and for a time he would not see or feel anything around him. Once, a cobra came gliding along the ground. The other boys were frightened and ran away, but Naren stayed where he was. They shouted at him, but he did not hear them. After some time, the snake went away. Later, his parents asked Naren why he had not run away. He replied, "I do not know anything about the snake. I was feeling very happy." Naren was happy when sadhus visited their house. He sometimes gave them valuable things. Once, he gave a piece of new cloth, which he was wearing, to a sadhu. After that, his parents locked him up whenever sadhus came to the house. But when Naren saw the sadhus, he would throw things to them through the window. Now and then he said that he would become a sadhu himself someday. Naren's father, as we have said, was a lawyer. Many people came to see him. He entertained them and offered them tobacco to smoke. There were different pipes for the different castes, but caste was a great mystery to Naren. Why was a member of one caste not allowed to eat with members of other castes? Why were there different tobacco pipes for the different castes? There was a pipe for the Muslims also. What would happen if he smoked from all the pipes? Would there be an explosion? Would the roof fall down? Naren decided to find out for himself. He took a whiff from one pipe. Nothing happened. He tried all the pipes in turn and took a whiff from each of them. Still nothing happened. Just then his father walked into the room and asked him what he was doing. Naren replied, "Oh father, why, I was trying to see what would happen if I broke caste." His father laughed and went into his study. Chapter 2. Young Naren at school and at play. When he was 6 years old, Naren began his studies. He did not go to school at first, as his parents got a teacher for him. He quickly learned to read and write. His memory was very good, and he could understand a lesson after hearing his teacher read it once. When he was 7, Naren was sent to the Metropolitan Institution. This school was started by Pandit Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. Narendranath was very intelligent and learned his lessons quickly. He became a leader among the boys. He enjoyed games very much. He would eat his lunch quickly and would be the first to run to the playground. Some of the games were jumping, running, boxing, and playing with marbles. Sometimes he invented new games. Sometimes Naren turned the classroom into a playground. He would talk to his friends and tell them stories even while the teacher was present. Once, the teacher saw them talking. He turned to Naren and his friends and asked them to repeat the lesson. All were silent except Naren, who was able to listen to the lesson and talk to his friends at the same time. He was able to answer correctly all the questions put by the teacher. Then the teacher asked them who had been talking. The boys pointed to Naren. The teacher did not believe them and made them stand up as a punishment. Naren stood up also. The teacher told him that he need not stand. But Naren continued to do so. He said, "I must, for it was I who was talking." One of Naren's favorite games was king and court. Naren, of course, was always the king. The court was held on a flight of stairs leading from the courtyard to the worship room. Naren took the highest step for his royal throne. He would then appoint his officials. One boy would be made prime minister and another the commander-in-chief of the armies. Some were made tributary princes or other government officers. Then they took their places on the lower steps according to their rank. In this way, Naren the king held his court. As a king, he gave orders, settled disputes, or put down rebellions. No one was allowed to disobey the king's orders. Sometimes he would order severe punishment to be given to a supposed rebel. The rebel would try to escape, but the king's men would chase him around the house and would finally capture him amidst much noise and excited shouting. Naren liked animals very much, and he would play with the family cow. He also kept pet animals and birds. Among these were a monkey, a goat, a peacock, some pigeons, and 2 or 3 guinea pigs. The coachman was a special friend of Naren, and he would often be found having intimate talks with him. Naren also thought that the sais or groom was a very grand person. He sat in the front of the carriage wearing a big turban and swinging a whip. Naren sometimes said that when he grew up, he would like to be a sais. He tried his hand at many games. Once in a while, he played at cooking also. He bought vegetables and spices and cooked various dishes. He was really a good cook. Another time, he organized a group of boys to stage plays. Then he became interested in physical exercise. He first started a gymnasium in his own courtyard and later joined the gymnasium of a neighbor. He took lessons in fencing, lathi play, wrestling, and other sports. Once Naren and his friends were trying to set up a heavy trapeze.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.